Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the previous video, we have discussed the different techniques of the AM generation, like AM generation using the analog multiplier and the square law modulator. So in this video, let us see one more method that is known as the switching modulator. So in the earlier videos, we had seen that the amplitude modulated wave can be expressed by any of these two expressions. And if we further simplify the first expression, then it can be written like this. So in any case, the first we need to multiply the carrier signal and the message signal. And then this signal needs to be added with the carrier signal. So it is easy to add the two signals. Even using the op-amp, we can add the two signals. But there are several ways to do the multiplication of the two signals. So in this video, we will see that using the switching operation also, it is possible to multiply the two signals. So let us see that. So let's say through the switch, the message signal MT is connected to some register. Now when the switch is closed, then the message signal will appear across the register. And when the switch is open, then the voltage across the register will be zero. So if you periodically turn on and off the switch at some frequency, let's say at FC, then the output across the register would look like this. That means whenever the switch is closed, at that time only we will get the message signal. And the same thing is equivalent to multiplying the message signal with a periodic pulse train of frequency FC. So if we multiply these two signals, then also we will get the same result. Now if we expand this pulse train using the Fourier series, then we can see that the product of the message signal and this phi of t contains our required term, that is MT times cos of omega CT. So first of all, let us represent this pulse train using the Fourier series. And for simplicity, we will assume that the amplitude of this pulse train is equal to 1. So this is how this pulse train can be expressed using the Fourier series. And here, this omega c is equal to 2 pi divided by tc. That is the time period of this pulse train. And these coefficients can be found using these expressions. Now here if you see, the pulse train is even symmetric. So all the coefficients of this sine term will be equal to 0. That means all bn will be equal to 0. And it contains only this a0 and the an. And in fact, this a0 will be equal to 1 by 2. So here, if we consider the period of this pulse train from minus tc by 2 to plus tc by 2, then we can write this integration as 1 by tc times integration minus tc by 2 to plus tc by 2 1 times dt. And here, since the pulse exists for minus tc by 4 to plus tc by 4, so we can write this expression as 1 divided by tc times integration minus tc by 4 to plus tc by 4 into 1 times dt. That is equal to 1 by 2. That means the coefficient a0 will be equal to 1 over 2. Similarly, this an can be written as 2 divided by tc times integration minus tc by 4 to plus tc by 4 times 1 times cos of n omega ct dt. That is equal to 2 divided by tc times sine of n omega ct divided by n omega c with integration limit from minus tc by 4 to plus tc by 4. That is equal to 1 divided by n pi times sine of n pi by 2 minus of minus sine n pi by 2. That is equal to 2 divided by n pi times sine of n pi by 2. And here, this n is varying from 1 to infinity. So as you can see, for the even values of n, this sine term will be 0. That means all the even coefficients of this an will be equal to 0. And for n is equal to 1, we will get this 2 divided by pi times sine of pi by 2. That is equal to 2 divided by pi. Similarly, this a3 will be equal to 2 divided by 3 pi times sine of 3 pi by 2. That is equal to minus of 2 divided by 3 pi. And in this way, we can find the different coefficients. That means if we see the function phi of t, then this phi of t can be given as A0, that is 1 by 2 plus 2 by pi times cos of omega ct minus 2 divided by 3 pi times cos of 3 omega ct plus so on. So in this way, using the Fourier series, we can represent this pulse train. And the product of this mt and the phi t can be given as mt times this 1 by 2 plus 2 by pi times cos of omega ct minus 2 divided by 3 pi times cos of 3 omega ct plus so on. That is equal to mt divided by 2 plus 2 divided by pi times mt times cos of 2 pi fct minus 2 times mt divided by 3 pi times cos of 3 omega ct plus so on. So this particular term gives us the product of the message signal and the carrier signal, and it can be filtered out using the bandpass filter. So still here, the discrete carrier term, that is AC times cos of omega ct, is missing. So this is the particular case of the double sideband suppressed carrier. That means if we just multiply the message signal with this switching function, then that is the case of the DSB-SC. Now in the conventional AM, it also contains the discrete carrier frequency term, that is AC cos omega ct. And for that, we also need to add the carrier term along with the message signal. So in that case, the output across the resistor R can be given by this expression. And if we further simplify it, then we can write it as mt divided by 2 plus 2 divided by pi times mt times cos of 2 pi fct plus ac divided by 2 times cos of 2 pi fct plus 2ac divided by pi times cos square of 2 pi fct. So here, these two terms gives us the AM signal, and it can be filtered out using the bandpass filter. So after the filtration, the output would be of the form 2 divided by pi times mt times cos of 2 pi fct plus ac divided by 2 times cos of 2 pi fct. And if we write it in terms of the standard AM expression, then we can write it as ac divided by 2 times 1 plus 4 divided by pi times ac times mt times cos of 2 pi fct. So if we compare it with the standard AM expression, then here the amplitude sensitivity, that is k, is equal to 4 divided by pi times ac. And here the amplitude of the carrier will get suppressed by the factor of 2. So in this way, by multiplying the carrier and the message signal with this switching function, it is possible to generate the AM wave. But the question is, how we can perform this switching operation? So the answer is, even a simple diode can also be used as a switch. That means whenever the amplitude of this carrier signal, let's say it is equal to CT, is much greater than MT, that is the message signal, then in that case, the on-off function of this diode will be driven by this carrier signal. That means whenever the carrier signal is positive, then this diode will act as a short circuit. And in that case, the message signal will appear over here. So at this point, if we see the output, then it will be similar to this function. And by passing this output through the bandpass filter, it is possible to get the AM signal. So this is how it can be implemented. That means here, this circuit is the bandpass filter. That means by passing the output through the bandpass filter, it is possible to retrieve the AM signal. So now let us see the same operation in the frequency domain. So let's say, this is the spectrum of the message signal. And after the switching operation, we will get this type of spectrum. So here, for the sake of convenience, only the positive side of the spectrum is shown. So here, this term is the message signal, that is mt divided by 2. Similarly, this carrier term is equal to ac divided by 2 times cos of omega ct. While this spectrum is equal to 2 divided by pi times mt times cos of omega ct. That means whenever the message signal gets multiplied with the carrier signal, then the entire spectrum will get shifted to the frequency FC. And all these are the higher order terms. So using the band pass filter, it is possible to recover the desired spectrum. So this is how we can design the switching modulator. Now in this switching modulator, since the amplitude of the message signal is much less than the carrier signal, so lot of power gets wasted in the carrier signal. And hence, the efficiency of this transmission will be very low. But anyway, I hope in this video, you got the general overview of this switching modulator. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.